Alrighty, I'm Kat, Kat Furrow of katfurrow.com, and I recently put a post out with me here in the studio, and I was painting on these two canvases, and this wall was full of art. Also, I don't know if you could see it in that post or not, but it was live, and I was just showing how I slap paint around, and I've had a lot of questions about my walls and how they're built. So one, I have to put plastic up because I got a little carried away yesterday and I realized, you know, better to be safe than sorry. I had to call myself Kathleen, but my given name, or rather I had to talk to Dolores, which is my middle name, and she's the honorary one. But Kathleen will keep me out of trouble. Kat likes to have fun. All those people out of one name. But anyway, back to the ranch. Plastic. So I am going to take these two down. I've already taken the six down. I have eight canvases going for this project. You may or may not be aware of my project, but I have eight canvases or eight pieces going as far as hope goes for 2022. And I'm going to put some plastic up. After I put the plastic, or I'm going to take the rails down, what I call the rails. I'm going to take the rails down, then I'm going to put plastic up, and then I'll put the rails back up. And I'll show you stuff along the way about it. Alrighty, love and hugs to you. I'll be back. Alrighty, I am back. All the screws are out. So I'm gonna take the rails down, or they're gonna come down. And then I'm going to put up plastic. I had this plastic on hand. This plastic is what I use when I'm traveling out on the road and I'm teaching and painting elsewhere. So I cover everything with this plastic. It's a very economical solution. Because I have it, that's why I'm using it. So I'll put multiple layers up just to be safe because I could very easily puncture it, wear it. So if you're out looking for plastic, I would get one at a heavier grade of plastic. Plastic comes in different grades, it's just multiple grades. So go for a heavier grade, it will last you longer. I will probably have to go through this process sooner rather than later. But I wanted to utilize what I had, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take the rails down and come back and show you when it's all taped up. Alrighty. So real fast, I thought I would note that if you look at the wall, there's plastic up and there's no tape holding it. Static electricity will secure your plastic to the wall for you, so it can be very easily a one-person job. So I just wanted to pause for a second. Because of that, it will also allow you to use less tape. So I'm just going to tack it up and go with it from there, and I'll be back. Okay, I just really want to show this because I want anybody, if I can do this, because I'm broken. I have a lot of things going wrong or right with my body, depending upon how you look at it. So if I can do it, really, I promise you probably can. But my box of plastic, because I did not measure the first go around because I'm a brat, but box of plastic, set the box of plastic at the far end of your wall, pull the sheet, the length of your wall, and then I have to make up. So I'm pulling it, plus, then I'm going to add scissors, cut, and then tape. Then I'll be back. Okay, I thought this would be beneficial. Let me move that. I just did an Instagram post. Quick one to show that, but these are secure. This wall is not. The boards are loose. Awesome. Before I anchored this first one, the screw, and then its partner over here. Before, because I didn't actually mark my lines. Had I marked my lines, I could just set it and be confident that I had the rails in the right place because I wasn't confident and I didn't want to play with the drill too much. I set them where I think I need them to be, and then I can test the location because of how the rail is designed up there. It's setting flush and it's relatively safe. What you want to be mindful of with this size canvas is the back side and how much space, the depth here. So when you're putting or making your measures, you measure from the back side if you're a person that measures, and I'm not a person that measures. So I eyeball it. I eyeball from the back side. It's my style. So I had to redo everything anyway because my center point, you guys may not have been aware, but my center was off. And it was driving me nuts with how my boards were, how the canvases were moving around. So I reset the wall. So that's what I'm up to. I'm going to reset the whole wall, and then I'll come back and show you the end. Thanks for paying attention. And I should have added, this section was a section that is new. So this is a new rail that I've put up that's separate of what I had up earlier. So earlier I had a makeshift doodah that I'd thrown together on the fly to get me through getting all the canvases up. And I lived with it until I didn't live with it anymore. So since I brought the everything down and put the plastic up, I can redo everything. I don't like to use tape measures unless I absolutely have to. So for me to just eyeball my plumb, I'm usually wrong when I'm eyeballing. So a tape, you can get a curve to your line a little bit when you're pulling, but it's relatively straight, relatively plumb. Particularly if you go straight across and line up the tape on the other side. And that's also assuming that that's assuming that the board is plumb. But while I screw that in, I just wanted to show that, and I think I will come back only for the end product. Okay, if you are still here, thank you very much for tuning in and paying attention. Everything is up and in place, and the only thing I am mindfully not appreciative of my skills is up at the ceiling. The ugly tape is going to drive me bonkers. I know that, so I will end up finding a different solution, making it more clean so my eyes don't go nuts over that. But everything else is nice and clean. And up, I'll put the dimensions of all the canvases up so you know how much wall space. And I have plenty more wall space that I could have smaller pieces up. As a matter of fact, I probably will put some small panels up to go along with this series. But I appreciate very much. I want to show you right here. See this table? Oh, pay attention to this table because I have something funny that I'm just going to say because I'm a little sassy. So if you did this for yourself, awesome job. Great, 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 great. If you did this for yourself and someone helped you do it, great, awesome. However it got done, applaud. Do yourself a favor, put all of your tools back in their tool bag and put them away in one location. Anything associated with your art room that is a tool, particularly with the rails, keep it in one space. Define its home where you can always go grab that little bag because it will save your mind in the process. And then clean up so that you can get ready and back in the studio. And also, if someone's helping you, be mindful. Don't nag. Accept imperfections because we're artists. And don't nag. Just say, tell them thank you, how much you love and value them. Be kind, be loving, be compassionate. Thank you for following. Love and hugs.